Is that what you're into?
Yeah. It's actually inspired my plastic surgery.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like very big boobs, very tiny little nose, yeah. tiny waist,
yeah.
and a cute bum. So that's like the look that I've been trying to go for. And when I turned 21, I had my first breast augmentation. It was 470cc. And then—
Was that silicone or saline?
Silicone.
All right.
But then when I woke up, I said, oh my God, no, they're still too small.
Right away.
Yeah. 7 months later, I got 800cc's.
So you doubled?
Yeah.
Same doctor?
Yeah, same doctor.
Without my permission.
Mm, you didn't tell mom you were going
She didn't
there.
Tell me. And I told her, your boobs look so big. And she said, no, mom, it's a dress.
But 800's a lot smaller than this. Right?
Yeah. yeah. I got them done again. 1600 cc saline.
Did you know about that one?
No, I was under my permission again.
She basically had secret surgery. Do you live at home?
Yeah, I live with my mom and my brother.
How did you hide going?
She told me I'm on a hiking.
So,
so I found
then
it.
then you come back home with these gigantic
yeah,
breasts?
Yeah, but I'm wearing a big sweater.
All right, so you went in to have the silicone 800s exchanged for 1600 saline.
Yeah.
Wow.
1 week later, I started to have fevers.
Just a fever, no breast pain?
No. So then I go to the ER, they ran some tests, and they told me that it was my right breast that was causing the problem, and that it was a staph infection. The plastic surgeon came, and he said, we're going to give you antibiotics mm-hmm. and perform an emergency surgery to remove the implant.
Right.
And I said, are you going to put something in? And he says, yes, I'll try to put an implant in, but it has to be a bit smaller.
What?
It's been like about 2 months since I've been out of the hospital and I feel fine.
How long were you on antibiotics for?
I'm still on them currently.
You got very lucky. Very, very lucky. When you keep an implant in a patient who has an active breast implant infection, even when you wash it out, you're subjecting that patient to a recurrent infection, a systemic infection that can be life-threatening, a capsular contracture, exposure. That's not something I would ever do. What other plastic surgery procedures are you planning as part of this process? Now, be honest, I know mom's here.
I want to get my nose done. I want a bridge more curved and more refined from the tip.
Like anime?
Yeah.
No, that's crazy.
What else?
I want to make this breast 1600, and also, in the near future, I want to go up to 2000 cc's, because that's my goal.
You told me you want to take the big one and leave the small one, and you want to change the big one for the small one.
Oh, sure. See, that's what
you told me.
By the way, mom, you're believing her?
You promised to me.
So you're not going to listen to your mom?
It's my passion. It makes me happy. It gives me a reason to live.
What if it kills you?
So why don't we go in the exam room and maybe we can give you some really good advice and help you, huh?
You're gonna hear some advice, but you're not gonna like it. I'm just telling you that right now.
You might like my advice.
Okay. You're not gonna like mine.